it's nice that either approach would be accommodated. Alright, so yeah, set tile, go to definition, go to declaration. Alright, so how did I do it for, yeah, I just switched it up. Alright, so if that's the case, then right, so it just disappears altogether. Right. So yeah, so switch on color. Case, what cases do we have? 0 through 6. Zero through six, actually. I said it correctly this time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, not 50, 6. All right, so case 0, tiles gobj dot transform dot get child 0. Get child should be capitalized. Right? What's with this lack of autocomplete? Sometimes Unity is like really pushy about autocomplete. Like it'll force autocomplete things you don't want autocompleted. And then other times it's just like, meh. Material dot main texture. Equals tile C index 0. Alright, what's your problem? Oh, I forgot to put in the index. PXPY. Save it. Actually, yeah, I can just do CLR. CLR. I can do this for all of them. Oh, yeah, that's true. So I can just do this for all of them, or for all of the first five. I don't have to break. And then for the last one. Oh yeah, I should also set it active, I guess, in case it was deactivated. Dot set active. Transform to get child. Dot game objects. Dot set active. Yeah, there we go. True. This guy, we do the opposite. We set active, false. Yay. Save everything, and now everything should be patterny. Ooh, that's woof. That's all I gotta say. All right, the other thing I want to do is this dot color equals palette color. Yep. So hopefully that'll be slightly less woof, but probably still be a little woof. Yeah, it's pretty woof. Pretty darn woof, if you ask me. So this is going to be an optional mode. It's not going to be on by default. So... If they were filled, maybe if they weren't like empty circles, maybe that would be better. I mean, I can try it. These files are easy enough to edit. I just need to make sure I leave them open in case I want to revert them. This is not a thing. This is not a thing. Is this a thing? Yeah. This is not a thing, right? No. I don't think so. No, it's definitely not. File open. These. Yeah, I hope something's open twice. Oh yeah, the circles. Open. These guys. Alright, let's see how that plays. I could save them separately. Nah, I'll just keep the document open. File save. File save. File save. Yep. Oh, wrong layer. Oh, right. This isn't the right, this isn't the correct file. This is the one with all of them. Oh, alright, so now I did mean to open the other thing. Oops. File open. Yeah, this one. Yeah, alright. So forget you. You're useless. Save. Yep. Save. This is probably going to be better. I'm probably still going to make it an optional mode because it's just really busy. If you don't need it, I think it's not preferable. Yeah. Come on, betterness. Betterness? I don't know. That might be better, it might be worse. It's kind of hard to tell. I think I like it better overall. I think I'm gonna keep it, I guess. Anyways. Oh, yeah. G-Man, how's it going? Sorry. Okay, I'll keep my phone chat again. I'm working in Google Docs to help me remember. Where are you forgetting some stuff? Yeah, I like Google Docs. It's good for just jotting notes, and they just automatically save, which is really nice. You can access them wherever. Yeah, I like those. Same for when I start a new project, I just make sure to write down the core essentials. Usually to-do list. Yeah, I tend to keep a backlog for my projects. Just because, like, there's some stuff that I know I don't want to do, like, today, but I know I want to come back to at some point. So, yeah, it's just helpful to have that going. So, is everyone is passively watching this? Oh, yeah, I'm, like, playing. Just kind of tuning in every once in a while. Yeah, I'm probably paying less attention than you guys are. I don't know. I think I'm, like, I'm just kind of like zenning out a little bit with the degree to which I could totally fall asleep if I let myself, and how like the I don't know the game's kind of on autopilot at this point, so yeah, why not? I don't know. So is there a party going on? What's going on? Oh yeah, so I'm at a public game jam right now, so there are a bunch of other people also working on their projects for the jam, so. A lot of them are working in teams, and so you probably hear them chatting in the background, and laughing and having fun. It's a good time. I might grab a quick snack soon, because I'm a little bit... Hey, Automotos, how's it going? Welcome back. Yep, it's dev o'clock. I just made all these weird bubbles appear, and then I'm gonna make them disappear. So it's like a magic trick, kind of. But I'm gonna make it so that the bubbles can reappear, if you choose. But it's gonna be like a secret. Whatever. I think the setup we have is probably satisfactory. It could have turned out a lot better, but heck, this whole project could have turned out a lot better, so I'm not going to worry about it. So, alright, I'm going to say bool shadows equals false, and then all those places that I referenced, like, what are they? Huole, dasi, and tileC. Let's find all those references. Wow. There's a few. So yeah, let's add the true and shadows. So now this will only actually evaluate to true if shadows is also true. And then the rest of the time it will evaluate to false. Along with all the others. Yeah. Was that all of them? Maybe, possibly. Let's try it again. False, true, false. Was there any other? Yeah, no, that was all of them. Then, yeah, the rest are not super important. But I guess I might as well only do it on shadows. Save that, and then Oh yeah, so that was one of them, and then the others are .c. Not as many here. Switch. So we'll only switch if shadows. Hey, we got a new follower. Pash BCC, or Pash B, sorry. It's really tiny text on my screen. Thank you for following. I actually had my headphones off. So if I missed other people following, thank you also to you people for following as well, because I don't know, getting new followers is like one of my favorite things, because I am a nerd and I like it when people like me. I do appreciate your viewership and your support, so welcome to the stream. And yeah, the reason I had my headphones off is because at like 4 in the morning, I've been streaming for the past like 26 hours or so, and at 4 in the morning, someone thought it would be a great idea to link in chat, like a link, when I clicked on it, it was just a clown face, like flashing rapidly, and just screaming through the speakers, and it was so loud, and I was so surprised that I started like yelling. And I have so many roommates. I have 3 roommates, and I'm pretty sure I woke them all up. And I'm pretty sure they're gonna hate me as soon as I get home. Like it was a really bad situation. But all right. Sorry. I'll get back to the dev stream. That was just I'm still a little scarred from that. Like it literally took me like half an hour just to stop like that. I wasn't literally shaking, but I had that jittery feeling for like a long time afterwards. It didn't help that earlier in the night we were telling like spooky stories. So, all right, yeah, we're jamming right now. We are game jamming, and I hope you like jamming too. sorry. Yeah, I put in a feature for like accessibility. I guess I only have to do this on shadows, but I don't like it I don't think it improves the title apart from the fact that it improves accessibility, so I'm going to make it optional and it's going to default to off, so I'm calling it shadows because it kind of looks like shadows. This game is based almost entirely around color, and it occurred to me it didn't occur to me until like very early this morning that like it would be impossible to play this game for a person who's colorblind. Yeah, obvious, but like, I don't know, it just completely slipped my mind. And I felt bad about that, so I wanted to make it at least playable. And I don't think it's like perfect, but I think it's better than nothing. I think it's worse than it could be though, which is why I'm setting it to be an optional default off type of thing. Alright, so oh, wait, actually. I might do the opposite approach on this one. What did I do for. Yeah, what did I do for the last one? Let me just double check. Oh, it was right here. Control Z, Z, Z. Yeah, is this legit? Yeah, I guess so. Oh, wait. I have to add in some more stuff for that. I have to add in an else case, because if not shadows, wait, where's if shadows? If shadows, oh, I actually didn't frame that accurately. Where's the switch end? Here. I need to add an else case where it is. C. This actually has to be 4. because we need the original dot structure for when we, yeah. Else, ta-da. No, not 0, 4. Or 3. Yeah, the default texture. So, yeah, similarly, we'll want shadows, we'll want an else case, wherein we just set this to false. Yeah, cool. Alright, hold on, sorry. Oh yeah, automatos. Alright, wow. I have no clue what time zone you're in. But it must be like the opposite side of the world. Yeah, thank you for tuning in. You probably left already, but sorry I wasn't paying better attention to chat. Yeah, oh my gosh. Pashby, sorry, I'm really behind on chat. I was super psyched about the game dev category. I actually, a month ago, I wrote to Twitch, and I, like, pleaded for them to add this, and they never wrote back, and they just, like, completely ignored me. I even, like, tweeted at them, like, hey, could you take a moment to respond to this thing that I wrote, maybe? That'd be cool. No, I wasn't even, like, passive-aggressive about it. I was just, like, well, no, I was a little passive-aggressive, but I was very polite in my passive-aggression. I'm super psyched that it's actually up and running now. It's, like, everything I could have hoped for and more. I don't know that's actually, well, because there's not just one type of colorblind. So like I know there's like red green colorblind, and like there are filters that you can put on to accommodate some people, but I didn't want to accommodate some people. I wanted to accommodate all people, at least in that particular regard. I know like literally a person who is not sighted whatsoever, like a person is not going to be able to play my game, but I don't know, it just felt like a glaring oversight, so yeah. Oh, Lion, sorry, I'm missing everyone's departure, but thank you also for tuning in. It's a pleasure to have you here. And I guess I'll just mention to everyone else, like, when you guys take off, like, I probably miss you leaving, but I definitely miss you once you've left. That is to say, like, yeah, sorry I don't pay further attention to chat. I think I, in general, I do, but I'm just really beat, I guess. That's how I can tell, like, I'm actually, like, legit tired, is that, like, I have zero acuity right now, and, yeah. I'll do my best. I'll just keep trying. I only have to hold out for, like, a relatively short while longer. Alright, so, yeah. Hi, everyone. It's nice to chat with you guys. Yeah. Yeah. thanks, Kinetic. Yeah. The, all my games are very hearing impaired friendly. They're perfectly hearing impaired friendly. In fact, they're probably even better if you're hearing impaired. yeah, I don't know. Anyways. Alright, so yeah. So we have shadows now. Shadows defaults to false. And I'm going to put in a secret method to enable it. I'm going to add in like a secret button. So on GUI... GUI, or no, it's in fixed, or not fixed update, it's in update, put mouse button down, press, so if modal prompt 1 is the one that we want, because modal prompt 1 is, modal prompt 1 is, the restart game option, and we're gonna do this on restart game. So if modal prompt 1, if button pressed, etc., etc., else, so I'll put it in here, else if button, else if button pressed. What do I want to use? Which button? I want to use restart or reset. Reset. Confirm. What's the other confirm? Retry confirm. Button. Press pause. As long as, yeah, I actually encourage people to share anything that they'd like to in chat. As long as it's friendly. Like if you post anything that is offensive, like the guy who posted the scary clown thing, I didn't ban him, I muted him, but like yeah, if anyone posted something truly offensive, like anything like just really distasteful or like anything that would be harmful to computer hardware, anything like that, then I would ban a person for doing that. But other than that, like for people who are legitimately trying to share something interesting, I encourage that. So yeah, please feel free to do so. In fact, I am literally delighted that you would do so. Let's see which category this falls in. All right, cool. This seems to be the good kind. Good job, Gavin. I'll check this out in greater detail off stream. Alright, so yeah, what do I have to do with shadows? Where did I even put it? Or where have I started putting it? Else if, there's gonna be a thing here, and then this is just the else. So else if button pressed, why are you not satisfied? Oh, because we need more parentheses. So yeah, let's say shadow star. Bool shadows false. Shadow time equals bool shadow time equals, no, it doesn't have to equal anything. Bool shadow dir equals 5 seconds. Not bool, dir. Neither of these are bools, these are both floats. Oh, my brain. Shadow dir. And we need one more, right? Shadow time, shadow dir. Gosh, it's as if I haven't slept in days. Shadow dir. That might be fine. Yeah. Oh. Shadow. Yeah, that should be fine. Okay. So what are we gonna do? Yeah, right, it's down in I can use my document outline. Like I never do. It's time to update. Button pressed. Input mouse button down. Not equals negative one. No, we want it to equal negative one. Alright, so like I said before, for a while we only cared about it. This other case, but now we have to care about it, and now we have to rearrange this because now we have to care about it in this case as well. So we have to nest this, and then we have another conditional as well. I guess it's an else, right? Because in this case, pressDRC is going to be negative 1, so else if shadow time is greater than time dot time. Wait, how's this supposed to work? Yeah, maybe I do need another value. Yeah, I'll just use another value. Alright, go to declaration. Also have rule shadow press. Shadow press equals false. I make weird typos when I'm tired. Alright, so back to update. Yeah, so button press. Oh yeah, never even put anything here. Shadow press equals true. Shadow time equals time dot time plus shadow dir. Save that. So, okay, so actually it'll be also if shadow press and if shadow, if shadow press, and, no, yeah, if shadow press, let's do the button pause thing, or the press whatever, button press pause thing. So if shadow press, screen press pause, or actually we don't even need to, we can say just button pressed, what is it, we're using the retry confirm button for this shadowy agenda. Wait, that's too many. Yeah, all right. Button pressed. Oh, yeah, so if shadow pressed. If not button pressed. If not button pressed. Shadow press equals false. Actually, I guess I don't need to use shadow press. I can use button press. Button pressed. Yeah. Actually, I'm going to use that instead. Go to declaration, get rid of it, touch to go back to where we just were. Yeah, so yeah, actually it'll be button pressed equals, wait, 0, 1, 2, 3, I've only used, so we'll use 4 for shadow press. Yeah, so instead of shadow press equals true, button pressed equals 4. So yeah, button press equals 4. Continue checking, because it needs to be a consistent press. If it's not a consistent press, then wait. No, maybe I should do shadow press. But I will still use button press equals 4. If shadow press, yeah, whatever. Shadow press is back. Welcome back. Button press equals 4. Well, no, I can just do shadow press. That's redundant. Shadow press. Shadow press equals true. Bring this back. Final references. Alright, yeah. Else. Else if shadow time is less than time dot time, then shadows equals true, and then we'll also do the stuff as if we to restart the game. Yeah. So what is it? It's like it's like this thing, I think, if I recall correctly. Yeah. It's basically like this thing. Anything else I need to do? Yeah, should be good. See that? So now, shadow starts as false, but if we press and hold here, we can restart the game, and the shadows will be on. And I think we can... Oh wait, I want this actually to be a way to toggle shadows, not necessarily just to turn it on. I want it also to be the way to turn it off. They're not gorgeous, but hopefully they're at least effective. So right, shadows not equals shadows. Or not equals, equals not shadows. Shadows equals not shadows. Yeah. Save that. I think with the rest of my time I might work on the Android port. Just cause, I don't know, just cause. Well, it technically works. I think 5 might be a bit long. I'm gonna try like closer to like 3. What version of Unity is this? Oops, hold on. About Unity. This is version 4.5.2F1. I downloaded it relatively recently. No, that's not true. I downloaded it a few months ago. And I don't know if I've updated it since then. I'm looking forward to whatever version... Yeah, I'm looking forward to whatever version has, like, the improved UI system, but until then, I can wait. this is free. This is not the paid version. This is not Unity Pro. This is just the one you get for free. I was going to make Shadow Time... or shadow duration public, save that, and then I think 5 was too long, like 3.5 maybe would probably be a better number. Yeah. Oh, really? New physics. That's cool. Alright, I'm gonna try restarting the game from like after having played a round or two. Is there an obvious one? I'm just missing it. I'm going the long way. Wish me luck. Uh-oh. Oh, cool. That works. Sweet. Alright, oh, this one's up. Blammo. Nope. No, the pro version, it has neat features, but you can do mobile stuff on the free version. This is easy. Easy enough for me. Oh, the levels that are trivially easy. Oh, the levels that are trivially easy. Oh, speaking of the levels that are trivially easy. Oh yeah, I wanted to try something else. Oh shoot, I should have done that before I turned it off. But I just remembered, I have a really low max... I have a really low pathmax dist. What if I jacked it up to like not having a max dist? What if it just went like forever? Not literally forever, but what if it just went as long as it could? Hey, Glitch H2A, welcome back. How's it going? Wait, buy the license? No, I think. Like I make mobile devices. Like if you go to my website, or I make mobile apps. If you go to my website. Any of the apps. I'm not a very good web developer yet, so the website looks dumb on mobile, but if you down at the bottom is a link to download the mobile version. I haven't bought anything from Unity, but yeah. The thing you get if you buy the pro version, it gets rid of this Unity loading screen. You can put in your own loading screen. And then like this little thing that pops out of the corner. So basically, like for the free versions, they advertise in your games. Basically, is how that works. But yeah, if you buy the pro version, you can get rid of all that stuff. And there are other cool features too. All right, I'm gonna see if I can just jack the pathmax dist, because it was a nice idea. But I think I just want it high all the time. High all the time. I keep you. Ooh, is this actually it? Oh, cool. Hey, look at that. No, if I go orange to blue... Oh, yeah, red to blue. Yeah, there we go. That couldn't have been the correct answer, but hey. How do I add sprites into a game? That's a really good question. I've actually never done that before. Alright, that sounds legit. I've heard that Unity is tricky with pixel snapping, but I've also seen people who make good looking pixel e games in Unity, so I don't know. Oh yeah, no, we got this. We got it unlock. Yeah. Yeah, there we go. Boom. Boom, shakalaka. Yeah, Light Up Man is lighting up the leaderboards in terms of questions answered today. And he's pretty good at IAMA as well, I'd say. Oh, these levels. These levels where, like, just basically everything's missing. Hilarious. What the? Where am I supposed to go? I guess here. Whoa, do I have to go like all the way around? I guess. I can't think of any other right place to go. Yellow. Green. Whoa. Am I gonna do it? Wait, green plus red is gonna neutralize me, but green plus yellow is yellow. Ah, orange, get out of my way. So wait, what if I go around? No, I can't go around. I'm gonna have to restart this one. Yeah, I failed. Trixie. Alright, so... Yeah, what the heck? Where am I supposed to go with this one? Orange plus blue is gonna neutralize. So I can't go there. Where am I supposed to go? Where am I supposed to go? It's all turning orange right now. Uh-oh, wait, no. Orange plus yellow is yellow. Plus blue is green. But this is the way I went last time, and I got stuck. Because green plus red is, green plus red is neutral. Oh, wait, but this is unneutral. Oh, yeah! Oh, my God! I was so worried about getting neutralized, I forgot that you can strategically get neutralized to traverse great ground. Yeah. Is that the crown up there? Oh. You know what I'm going to do? Is I'm going to, I think I'm going to make these fade in and fade out. Maybe? I don't know. They just take up too much screen space. Maybe? If I want to do the mobile port, I should probably do the mobile port first. I could do, I could do mobile, and then I could fix, and I could do multi-touch to survey the game world, survey the map, maybe? Yeah, I think I'm gonna go in that direction at this point. Oh, I still haven't, sorry, I'm just gonna check one more thing about shadows, just to make sure it's, like, stable-ish. Uh-oh, where am I going? Where am I going with this? Oh, wait, I know. Yellow, orange, yay. Right. Light up, man. You light up my life. I'm sorry, I'll stop making jokes involving the phrase light up. But thank you. I don't know, it's just my fave. I haven't published any of these games yet. I mean, you can play them on my website, but I haven't actually like put them in any of the stores yet. There's a lot that I have to do to get any of these. Like, there are a lot of little features that have to go into to get these like really polished up and ready for a release like that. So I haven't gotten to that point yet, but I'm getting to the point where like that's kind of like the next thing on my agenda is to, like, instead of starting more new projects, I kind of want to, you know, actually start doing that sort of thing. So I'll let you know as soon as I'm able to get there. That's going to be like kind of a new adventure to me because I have a lot of experience prototyping. I don't have as much experience on the publishing side. Like I kind of understand it just having worked in the games industry for as long as I have, but I still don't have that like that the actual like firsthand like I've just literally never myself published a title. I've worked on titles that have been published, just they've always been published by very competent publishing departments at the companies I've worked for. So I'm just setting up my my phone now so I can deploy on Android. Hopefully it kept its charge. Hopefully. Seems good so far. This thing runs out of batteries so fast, and it takes years to charge. I don't understand how that works. Thank you, Glitch HD, right? Man, sometimes I think about other things, like, to do other things with my life. But, like, why would I want to do other things with my life when I can make games? I don't know. The one thing that's always seemed strange to me is that, like, in my experience in the games industry, everyone's always really young. Like, I don't know, like, almost everyone I've worked with has been, like, relatively young. Like, there have been some people who are, like, older that work in the games industry, but it seems like older people are, like, very few and far between. And so I always wondered to myself, like, am I going to have to leave the games industry someday? Like, do people just have to leave the games industry at a certain age? Like, do you get kicked out at a certain age? Or, like, how does that work? Because there don't seem to be as many. My friend, like, tried to reassure me that, like, it's probably just because video games weren't as popular in older generations. So, like, a lot of the people who are, like, older right now, like, they didn't grow up with video games the way we did. And so it wasn't as big a part of their life. I tend to forget that, but fortunately I also sometimes tend to remember it. So, yeah, hopefully that's all that's about. Because I don't know, I just really enjoy what I do. So I'm glad you guys can enjoy what I do as well. build settings. Oh, yeah, we can exit play mode for a second. I can also hide these because they, by default, they are actually hidden. So, yeah, anyways, not that that matters, but whatever. Alright, so build settings. The font. I need to change the font. Oh, actually, I haven't really checked anything in Free Aspect on this title. I might have screwed up everything for all I know. How does it actually run? Nope, that font definitely... that font seemed okay, actually. Well, I mean, the UI... Oh, right, that's... The buttons might get cut off, which would be obnoxious, because I don't have screen shrinking. So what should I do about that? I could use the camera size, orthographic camera size. Like VBox. I could do what I did in VBox. So open, not open scene, sorry, open, mono develop file. Open, projects, VBox, assets, what is it, zoom? Zoom.cs. Yeah, here we go. So on start, this. So yeah, we need a new script for our camera, main camera. Add component. New script, zoom. I mean, I guess I could kind of use the same script, because I'm basically going to do exactly that, but whatever. It'll be a new one. Whatever. Same diff. Yeah, cool. And then there's one other thing that we need to do for the text. Open solution. No, whoops. That's not what I meant to do, actually. File. Open. So the thing I just did is so before, like, when like the screen was like scrunchy and like. Because, like, phones have, like, a taller aspect ratio, they're much narrower. Not that much, but, like, I don't know, maybe something more like that. What I did is now when the title boots up, the UI text doesn't change, but everything else gets a little scrunchier and towards the middle of the screen. Like, so... So, yeah. So now the next thing I have to do is I have to fix up the text so that the text plays nice as well. Actually... Huh. Yeah. I have to do the same thing to text. Alright, so this is going to be slightly fumbly and slightly awkward as well. Oh, wait. Actually, no. What if I just use 3D text instead? Yeah, I'm totally going to do that. Die. Level number. Die. game object creator, the 3D text.
Yeah,
I like 3D text. It's three-dimensional, amongst other things. This color, I guess? I don't know. Zero, zero, zero. No, wait, no. Zero. I don't know where this is supposed to go. Go, yeah, there we go. Something like that. Except really far away. Oh, wait, it's orthographic. Oh, no, it's orthographic. Oh, no, it's orthographic. It's orthographic. Oh, wait, no, I know how to fix that. Yeah, that's fine. Alright, so, zero, whatever. I'll scale it. I'll scale it down to 0.1. 0.1. 0.1. I guess upper center. Zero. Whoops. Wait, what? Oh. Wait. Oh, right, yeah. I remember. Yeah, so parent this to main, I guess, or whatever. Yeah. And then it'll move around appropriately. And then text font size, like 60? Well, no, more than that. 120? Too big. 100. Alright, maybe this will just work. That'd be great. level number. Zombies? Oh. Oh, cool. Ooh. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. That looks really sharp. Benjiko, that... yeah, that looks pretty rad. Oh, sorry. I did that thing where they got zoned out and I stopped paying attention in chat. Honestly, I might actually do that a little bit more because it's getting down to the wire. And so, The deadline is at 5 o'clock, and they're going to start calling stuff at like around 4 o'clock. So that only gives me like one more hour of like solid dev, and then not much more time to like hustle and scramble, et cetera, et cetera. So yeah, 7.5, I guess it's probably better. Okay, so not that that matters. Zero. Alright, so, yeah. Alright, so we need to change, oh yeah, actually, let's just make sure this even works. Oh, well, it's going to freak out, because it's going to, yeah, sorry, it's going to freak out because of the exceptions, because I didn't hook up the new text yet. Forgot about that. Oops. Probably should have done that first. Alright. Well, it's crashing. I'll check out chat. Alright, it's uncrashing. Alright, so yeah. Level number. Yeah, every time where it had said GUI text, now we want to say, for some reason, you have to get component in order to address text mesh. Text mesh. Oops, not 90. Open close parentheses. Alright, yeah, so yeah, where we used to reference level number, yeah, that's fine, yeah, place this, yeah, I guess text meshes are perfect for, like, orthographic cameras. It didn't work for my perspective camera, but, yeah, I really don't like GUI text. It's just so fumbly and awkward. Yeah, no, this is perfect. So, yeah, save projects. Oh, yeah, I need to set up my build, et cetera, et cetera. Build settings for Android, player settings. There's this thing about, like, other settings. Yeah, I need to set this to bz.srsly.im. And then I don't care about the rest of that stuff. Cool. Cool. I don't know. The rest of that stuff's probably fine. Oops. Oh, I was clicking on different things. Android. Yeah, the rest of it's probably fine. Yeah. And then. Yeah, I think we're ready to build. So build and run. Build. We'll call this P2, I guess, because why not? Save as iama.apk. And this part isn't going to be as interesting on stream, but here, I'll see if I can position my device so that you guys can see it as well. There we go. Kinda. Wait, now I can't see it. Hold on. It's kinda hard to show both at the same time. That might work a little bit. Doop doop. Almost ready. Almost ready. Here, I'll let you guys see it first. It's almost there. Oh, look at that. Oh, is it going? Is it going? Is it going to work? Oh, I see a logo. I can't tell what I see. Oh, that didn't work. What happened there? That's weird. It's like off in the corner or something. Oh, it's like doing this. What the heck? Why is it doing that? Why on earth is it doing that? Oh, because we're still... Oh, because I still haven't assigned... Yep. Alright. Just because I added the text and said it doesn't mean the level number will automatically, etc., etc. So, save that. Oops. Save that. Build and run again. That was nerve-wracking for a moment. Oh yeah, I should capture my chat. well, that's better. I should probably make sure the build is working on my PC before I keep trying to make Android builds. Now it's working here. Oh. Does that mean it's just legit not working on my device? That'd be sad. Usually, it ports fairly cleanly. I can't think of any specific reason why this one wouldn't. Build again, I guess. I don't know. If at first you don't succeed, build again. I don't know. Please work. Please work. Maybe I just have to like uninstall it or something. Alright, I'll catch up on chat. Yeah, Kinetic. Early 30s, that's where it's at. Oh, cool, look at this. Hey, look at that. Look at this. Hey, have you guys played this game before? It's really cool. It's this really cool game. Super cool. alright, seems legit so far. Yay, we did it. The stars popped up and everything. Here, I'll do one on camera. Alright, how do I get there? I guess yellow to red, probably. Yeah. Can you see it? Oh, sorry, not really on screen. Yay, we did it. We ported to mobile. So yeah, now let's do the thing about, currently we're using press and hold as, what was I talking about? Oh, right, like it's a stupid movement function, but, let's do the press and hold to pan the camera thing instead. I guess it'll be elastic, so you can like stretch it in various directions, but then it'll go back to, it'll, when, as soon as you let go, it'll go back to wherever. And I guess we can actually, I mean, this isn't just a mobile specific feature. It's, we can do this on, we can do this on PC as well. Yeah, because the, I mean, the controls aren't perfect, but, oops, sorry. I still need to catch up on, sorry. Yeah, alright, so let's see if we can't pull this out real fast. Real quick. What do you do? Alright, so, so yeah. We can forget all of this, all of the stuff in the current, what is it? Mouse get button down. We can just get rid of all of this. I'm just gonna comment it out. Straight up. So, so, actually, let me just make sure that that doesn't break anything straight up. So, alright, you can still move around. I'm not good at this game. I know, I'm stuck. I'm entombed. Wait, where am I supposed to go? Oh, yeah, that's right. alright, yeah, so I didn't break the controls yet. So what are we going to do? What do we actually want to be doing in order to get the desired effect? Like, what do we want to be changing in the game to get that effect? I guess... What? Oh, this is what happened when I launched it on mobile once. It, like, forgot to position the hero or something. I don't know what that's about. That's clearly a bug of some sort. So, yeah. In order to move it around, I guess we want to... We can't move main. I guess we just have to move the camera. Yeah. I think we just have to, like, move the camera around. So I should probably parent the, buttons so that they parent the UI to the camera, because otherwise it's a little weird when it doesn't, come with. Oops, no. Yeah, so, alright, so in play mode... Yeah, when you move, when you make these gestures, what you'll be doing is moving the camera around. And so, yeah, just to see what that actually looks like in a practical sense. If the board were really big, like if it was 20 or like, yeah, 20 by like 28 or something, and you were playing. Then yeah, moving the camera around would have an effect like, yeah, I don't know if the board will actually even ever get this big, but like, you know, hypothetically, it could, or something, and you'd want to look around, maybe, although, of the board is this big, and it puts the crown right freaking there. That is amazing. I hope the correct answer is to like go all the way up and like but no, there's probably a super quick direction. Anyways, yeah, so we're probably gonna do that. We don't actually address the main camera directly, so let's start doing that. Game object public game object camera save that main camera so there we have press pause, we have the original press pause, right? Yeah, we have press pause. So, because when we click down, we get press pause, and that sticks. That doesn't get overwritten during this mode. So, well, sorry, I don't know what's going on in chat right now, but play nice, I guess. Sorry, I'll try and catch up on it, but I'm also like running really late, and I don't want to miss this deadline. But you are both lovely people. Light Up Man, I know this personally. Benjico 99, I assume so, because you seem really cool. You've given a very great first impression. I don't know if you're actually squabbling, but I hope we can all get along. If I've misread the situation, I apologize, and I will stay out of your business until I can properly read over chat. All right, so what are we going to do here instead? So we're going to take a new press pause, kind of. We're going to say, Vector 3, right? Okay. All right. I know what I'm trying to do. Not button pressed. Yeah, camera, main rate, et cetera, et cetera. Vector 3, hold pause, equals this. Was this? Are there too many parentheses? Equals this, and then camera dot transform dot position. Yeah, how does that work? I mean, it's orthographic, so it should be fairly straightforward, right? Like, in order to get to the side of a really big thing, you go to the side of it. Yeah, perfect. 19. Oh, that's interesting. You go the. Oh, right, no, right, because it starts in the center. Right, okay, yeah, alright. Alright, no, this should be fairly straightforward, I hope, maybe, possibly. Oh, yeah, alright. I'm going to institute a delay. So, press time. Do I already have press time? No, I was going to put in press time and then it said I didn't need it. I remember that. That was a long time ago. That was like the very first start of the project. Oh wow, so actually it was yesterday, but it feels like a very long time ago. Press time. Float press time. Press pause. Go find references. Yeah, so press pause, press time equals time dot fix time. Save that. And then right, oh yeah, and then also go to declaration, press time, and then public float press pan delay. Equals I don't know, like 0.2 seconds. So you have to be holding down the you have to be holding down for 0.2 seconds before it actually starts panning. Find references down here. So yeah, so if so here if press time if press time plus press pan delay is less than time dot time, then we'll do these things. We'll say camera position. Oops. Oh no. No, we actually don't want to do like that. We don't want to use this. We want to use we just want to use input mouse position. Which is a vector 3, apparently. I think we found out last time we tried to use this. Alright, so. Vector 3. Well, I'm gonna call it like new vector 3. Input mouse position dot x divided by screen dot width comma screen dot float screen dot width. I don't know if that matters. Input dot mouse position dot y divided by the line break, because I've been doing actually pretty good about line breaks on this project. Float screen dot height and then 0. Camera dot transform dot position. Actually, these are going to be 1 minus. 1 minus. 1 minus. Local position. Local position of the camera. Main camera. Right. So we need to use relative. We need to use world position. And then we need to snap it back to local position. Negative 10. Right. Camera position. Camera dot transform dot position equals. Equals what? New vector 3. This is a little bit silly math, but whatever. It doesn't need to be perfect, it just needs to be. Hey, Dano King! Welcome back! Sorry, I'm not being a great host right now, but that's because I'm like racing the clock right now. The good news is that I'm racing the clock and feeling good. I'm not like racing the clock and feeling like super stressed. So yay, I guess. I will catch up on chat because people have been chatting, and feel free to continue chatting and feel free to participate in chat. But I'm hacking in a last minute camera control system because I realized like the best way to make this game more fun is to to add the challenge and to add that feeling of like ratcheting, like, you know, ramping it up, is to make the map bigger and bigger and bigger. And unfortunately the screen is like doesn't work great that way, so I'm gonna add in hopefully we'll see it actually hopefully pretty soon. So vector 3 equals I inverted it. No, I'm gonna invert it here instead, because So if you're at the max, you only be at the bottom. So yeah, 1 minus so grid x max times 1 minus 1 minus hold pause dot x, and that's a term. Maybe? I don't know if this is going to make sense. I hope this makes sense. Grid y max. Grid y max times, I'll line break it again because I care, times 1 minus hold pause dot y I hope this makes sense. 0. Oh wait, no, negative 10. Because that's where the camera lives, at negative 10. Not negative 100. Nah, not that it matters. I mean, it's orthographic. Save that. I'm building for Android presently. It would work on an iPad if I had a Mac. In order to build for iOS, you need a Mac device, a Mac computer to compile Xcode, which I don't have yet. But I have friends who said they could like lend me their MacBooks or whatever, and then I'm thinking of just getting a Mac Mini. I haven't actually started releasing my projects yet, but that'll be vital to do. All right, and then. Could it really be this simple? Could it really just be a matter of that, and then also on mouse up, snapping it back to reality? Is that, could it be, could it possibly, dare I to dream, DRC equals negative 1, no, the other one, DRC equals, yeah, no, the other one. Press on, move up. Not equals. Camera transform position. No, not camera transform position. Camera transform local position. Local position. Because we snap it back to its local position. Equals its home. It's. It's a happy place, 0, 0, negative 10. What is that going to do? Is this going to do something good, something crazy? Press move on up. I think I'm also going to deactivate press move on up. Once we go into this mode, first move on up equals false. All right, here we go. This could be it. This could be you guys. This could be great. All right, so now if you press and hold, no, nothing. Nothing? Nothing at all? Is it frozen? No, it's not frozen. Oh, there we go. Yeah, look at that. Look at how I'm surveying the map. Look at how I can survey the entire map. Alright, that's pretty rad. I like it, I think. I mean, it might be a little jarring. It works best if you start in the... Oh no, actually, it works best if you start where you are. So that's a little bit, etc., etc. I might want to make the dude guy stand out a little bit better. Just because he's kind of, like, subtle. I don't know, he kind of stands out. But he's kind of subtle. So maybe in this mode, I'll make him more noticeable or something. I don't know. I mean, yeah, in this mode, yeah, that's fine. So, what is the skill usually? It's usually 0.75, so I'm going to add a hierarchical game object so that his scale is usually 0. Create empty. Go on main and be a hierarchical zeroed out game object. Also named who, because why not, whatever. Go up here. Hey, we got a new follower, BenjiKo99. Thanks for following. Sorry, I'm not being a very good host right now. I usually try and be more interactive, but like I've said a few times, Oh yeah, thank you, BenjiKo99. Yes, that is in fact my website. BenjiKo, the virtual machine thing. So other people have mentioned that before, but. I don't know, yeah, so it's probably worth looking into. I don't know. You can get a Mac Mini, though, for, like, $60, so I might just go that way. I don't know. I've never set up a virtual machine before, so maybe that'd be a good thing to learn. But yeah, thank you again for following. Oh, more followers! Skybox's PC, thank you. Thank you for following as well. I appreciate your support and your viewership. This is just always way more fun when there are people to hang out and chat with and have a good time with. I know, like I said, I'm not being very interactive right now, and I apologize for that. But I think if this looks good, I'm probably just gonna call it. I'm just gonna call it and then I think that's like game basically. Maybe I'll like just play the game and like work on bug fix. Oh, you know what I'll do? I'll put up a build and then you guys can play it too. Because I think it's actually significantly better than the morning build. So yeah, let's do that. I guess maybe probably. All right. So the scale is 1. Typically, and then what's the scale on crown? Typically 0.6. So yeah, same thing. Create empty game object, reset, etc. Oh wait, so if we do this, we just have to change what crown is in the, because now crown is this instead of this. So main crown is now this instead of. I mean, they're both called crown, but whatever. Then yeah, this, so this will. Like cheap on eBay, you can get a really old Mac Mini, like used or refurbished, or like I don't want a Mac. I don't have any interest in a Mac. I have a fine computer. I don't need a Mac. I just need something that'll compile Xcode. So, like a old beater device, like I don't care. I'm not going to use it for literally anything except for to compile Xcode. So, yeah, yeah. So to me, like anything is literally anything is fine. All right. So I think the other thing I'm going to do in this mode is say we're gonna do some sign of the, we're gonna see the sign of the times here. Is my really stupid way of saying. I kind of want these things to like pulse just so that they're noticeable. So, I think yeah. So, flow or crown dot. Oh, do I even reference the, do I even reference who? Yeah, no, I do, because I changed the color and stuff. Crown.transform.localscale equals vector 3, equals vector 3, new vector 3, 1 times math f dot sine. Time dot time. I am a complete nerd. This is what I meant when I said sign of the times. I used to use Visual Studio, and I think I prefer it to Mono Develop. I should probably switch to it because like there's an Express version. I don't know. I used to use like the real version, and I always assumed the Express version would be like really bad, but it might be better than Mono Develop. I don't know. I get by in Mono Develop. There are a lot of things that I miss in Visual Studio, just about it, like, being a more developed, like Mono Develop feels like the generic, like, feature, like it doesn't have nearly as much of, like, the sophisticated, like, rich features that you get in Visual Studio. I don't know, it's hard to describe, but Visual Studio just, like, feels, like, more powerful. It feels, like, snappier, or not snappier, but like it feels like it has like real weight behind it, whereas like Mono Develop feels a little more like plastic, I guess. I don't know. I don't know how to describe it exactly. Plus math, sign, time. Yeah, sure. And then same thing for who. Transform dot local scale. And then the other thing is and then when this is all over, it just goes back to that. Alright, I wonder what this will look like. I honestly have no idea. Alright, so what is that thing that's like flying across the screen? Does anyone else see that? What the heck? Did I accidentally do like transform position or something? I meant to do transform.localScale. Yeah, I did local scale. I swear there was something like flying across the screen. I have no clue what that was about either. Well, I'll go take another look. But apparently I meant to say vector 2, 2. Oh no, not here. Here is 1, 1, 1, and then apparently up here I meant to say 2, 2, 2. Two. Oh no, it's multiplied by mathf.sign. So no, actually I meant to say. Oh yeah, no, I meant to say. Well, alright, I'll just say flow. ST equals this, and then 1 plus ST for all these terms, and then it's not 11. And where'd my end parentheses go? And you can no longer be needed. 1, 1, 1. Alright. Maybe this is better. What was that thing that was flying across the screen? Alright, I feel like I'm really close. I feel like I'm like right on the verge. Why does it keep getting minuscule? I don't want it to get so minuscule. 1 plus sign. So I guess 2 plus, no, 1 plus, so alright, let's divide this by 2, I guess, or divide by 3, I guess, because I just want it to be pulsy enough to notice. Let's also do times 1.5, because it was pulsing a little slowly, so, I swear, there's still something flying across the screen. Maybe I hallucinated that, but could have sworn I saw that. Yeah, no, there's definitely something flying across the screen over here. What on earth is... Oh, the crown. Why the heck is the... Oh, I'm an idiot. Alright, I know why the crown is flying across the screen. It's because the crown has a different offset. It's not at 0, 0, 0. It's, Well, yeah, I can reset that, I guess. Oh, no, wait, no, this one has to be at 2, though. And then crown can get reset, I guess. Well, no, I'll just put this one to 992. Just because that's how I'd been seeing it. Oh, wait, what? Oh, wait, no, I wasn't supposed to reset it, actually, because... Okay, so yeah, now I'll zero out these two values, and I'll put these up to 9. Yeah, great, so it stays the same size. Alright, cool. Now workage, I think. Now it's gonna just super work, I swear. Just super mega work all day, all night. Hmm. So maybe... Huh. Yeah, they're getting really small. I just want them to get mostly bigger, not smaller. And I think I actually meant to say times 0.7, not 1.5. Maybe? No, wait. Which one would make it pulse faster? Maybe it just wasn't pulsing. I forget. Anyways, the pulsing was still a little too much. So let's say times 0.25F, but also with a bigger base, so like 1.5, 1.5, 1.5, 1.5, 1.5. Oh, it occurs to me I could just add this into ST, and then I won't have to do it like a gazillion times over. Plus, and then these can just go ST, ST, ST. Yeah, it's probably easier. Save that, and then space, space there, whatever, save that. Alright, so, I tried to stream about 30 hours a week. I didn't stream much this week because I knew I'd be doing this marathon stream. I've so far, like, I might actually hit pretty close to 30 hours of streaming just from this weekend alone. And I also streamed on Tuesday, and I'm probably, I might not stream tomorrow, but I'm probably going to stream again starting on Tuesday, because I think I'm starting a new project tomorrow. Pretty sure. I'm pretty sure I'm starting a new project on Tuesday, so yeah, so that should be fun. The next project that I'm working on, I won't go into too much detail because I could talk for too long about it, and I will on stream eventually, but it's going to be a chat-based game, so it's going to be like based in Twitch chat, so people who watch the stream can play the game as it's being developed, which will be a little bit chaotic, but you can also play it as you watch the stream, and then once it's finished, it's going to be... I used to work in AAA. I'm working indie now. I'm working independently. I haven't started publishing anything yet, so just on Tuesday, I finished my third portfolio piece, and I wanted to put together three portfolio pieces. That was my goal before I started, like, really diving into any one thing. So one of my next goals is to start like commercializing my products as well. So look for them soon. And if there's one that you especially like, feel free to let me know. I can start prioritizing. I don't know. I like my projects in different ways. So I have to error in the compiler. So what did I forget? Too many parentheses. Not enough parentheses. Too many parentheses. Yeah. Save that. I worked at a studio called Harmonix Music Systems. They made Rock Band and Dance Central and some other games as well. Yeah, so like I had 6 years. I worked in AAA for like 6 years, so that's where most of my experience is. And then I have some additional. What are you? Am I missing a cast? Are you missing a cast? I don't know. Oh, F. F, F, F. Excuse me. Do you guys want to see the game? Sorry, I'm really close. Press move time. It's never used. Press move time. What was press move? Okay. wait, what was the question? Oh, did I do a class in game dev? Oh, sorry. I'm sorry. I've been neglecting chat, and I apologize. I never studied game development. I got my degree in software development, but for like enterprise software. like I was on track to like make payroll software and like tax and accounting software. But then for my final senior project, I decided to make a guild manager for World of Warcraft guilds, which was basically like an HR system, but for raiding. And at that point, I was just like, I know where my heart is, and so I went after it and never looked back. I really don't ever wonder what my life would have been like. What the heck? Wait, why is that so big? That's way too big. That dude got way too big. Why are you so big? Who are you? Oh, because I probably reset coordinates like I did with the other one. Oh, how big are you supposed to be? No, you're supposed to be myself. Oh, it's because I never changed the address. So who? Oh, ooh, oh, ooh. I think it's. I wouldn't typically advise this specifically, but I'm gonna just do something kind of hacky because I'm right at the end here. I'm just gonna. So I'm gonna have. I'm gonna, instead of changing all the references to who, I'm just gonna add in who. Or public game object who shell, because I just actually just want to reference the shell for this one purpose, but I want to reference the actual the other one for most other purposes. So whoops. Anyways, yeah. So final references to who, and yeah. This one I actually wanted to reference who shell. Who shall save all that? All right. All right. This could be it. This could be the final one. This could be the build to end all builds. All right. So that is big, and then it shrinks back down. So that's good. All right. A crown's down here. I think that's pretty good. I think it still pulse a little bit faster. I guess I should make those things public. But whatever. No, we're right at the end here, so there's no point in getting fancy now. All right, so I guess I'll put this to like 0.35. It's slightly more dramatic pulsing. I'll put this to 3.5. For slightly faster pulsing, and let's see how that goes. Wait, and then 1.5. I could probably do like 1.25 instead. Save that. Although actually maybe I should have stayed at 1.5 because maybe this will make the pulsing too dramatic. That's pretty good. It could still pulse a little faster. I want it really to be like noticeable, like really eye-catching, so it like just kind of like jumps out at you as you're scrolling around. So also probably make it a little bit bigger too. So 0.5 and then also times 0.45. Maybe even 0.5. Just 'cause. And then yeah, faster, faster, faster. All right. Yeah, sorry, I do it when I'm thinking. I know that's probably obnoxious, and I can try and hold off. I can abstain. Sorry. It's probably like super boring to watch. Here, wait, what if I put my chin below camera level? No, you can't tell. No. Sorry. Sorry. All right, I think we're almost there. So once I get this, I think I'm gonna put the build up on. That might be a little too fast. All right, yeah, let's scale it back slightly. I like the amount of pulsing, but yeah, I think we overdid it just ever so slightly. So for the speed, yeah, let's tone it back down to like 5.2 maybe. I really should have exposed these, but whatever. Cool. What's that? Sounds like a fun goal, though. I'd probably play a revamped version. Alright, just one possibility thing. I want to change. What? I want to change. This is just like super tiny last minute sort of thing. Wait, what is new material? Is this actually used for anything? I'm not going to delete it at this step, but like, I don't know. Alright, yeah. Oh yeah, and before I build it again, I should make the game scale a little bit better. I kind of want to lighten this up. Is that? That's probably still fine. I just want that to be lighter. I just want it to read lighter to make it read better against the. Or maybe I should make the other ones darker. Maybe I'll drop this back down ever so slightly. And then you drop the other ones down a little bit slightly as well. Which I would do over here. And it won't take effect immediately, so I actually shouldn't do it in this mode. Alright, how about that? Yeah, that's better. I just want a more dramatic contrast between those two. Alright, and so now let's put the game field back down to like regular size. 7, 8, I think was the best size I could come up with, or the one that felt the best. So yeah. Wait, where am I going? Quick, there we go. Ha. All right, I think I'm gonna put this build online. Think I'm gonna call this good, and then I'm probably gonna find terrible bugs, and then I'm have to gonna make it. Gonna have to make a new build, and I don't know. We'll see. Oh wait, where am I going? There we go. Yeah, look at that. All right, yeah, I'm gonna put this build online. Oh, and I'm gonna build it for Android stuff too. I guess I could put the Android build online as well. I'm gonna switch over to Facecam just 'cause I don't know. Just 'cause, hey, internet, it's my face, sorry. Alright, so build settings, I'll go for the web player, build P2, there's gonna be a million build twos, I'm building, building build twos for a long time to come. Oh, I guess I should. I mean, I could put up the version of the. I can put up the Android link, I guess, because I'm building it for Android anyways. So hold on, let's see. Build. Hero. No. Projects. AMI. Build P2. Drop that there. Yeah. What is going on here? Web player, yes. Build. Oh, you just did. I just did that. Don't have to do that again. Alright, build. Quick start edit with this thing. I'm a jigger. So hero, place that with I am a. Find next, place that one also with I am a. Oh, I didn't test to see how the camera controls feel on the mobile device, but hopefully that'll be okay. What's the other thing? Tap. No. Next. Start at the top of the thing. I believe in you. Or click. Maybe not click. Yeah, click, not tap. All right. Sorry. I'm almost done. But stop. I said click, not tap. All right, so yeah, what is this like the little instructional help for IAMA? like Get the Crown or something like that. Yeah, Get the Crown. I'll do it with an exclamation point this time. Get the Crown! Exclamation point. Yay! Alright, so, alright, save that. Save that now. And then, this stuff with the connection and the hey. Sorry, this is probably even more boring. Now, not only am I being distracted, but you can't even see what I'm being distracted by. I'll switch back to the regular camera in just a moment. I'm create a new directory, P1, put the old stuff in the other directory, new stuff in this directory, wait, go up, P2, quick start, IAMA.apk, build, Unity. Probably should have tested it locally before I just threw it on the internet, but eh, it's not really my style. No, I think this is still the old build. Yeah, this is still the old build. Ugh. So, annoyingly, sometimes my browser caches an older version of a build, so just in case that happens, I'm gonna put a new folder for the build as well. It'll be the new one. In case your browser caches the old version, you can get to the new one by going to srsly.bz/IAMA, that's IAMA, /P2. And then if you want to see the older build is in P1, so you can check that out. And I think that should be all set now, hopefully. So I'll switch back over to screen cam. So for source control, I use GitHub because it works fine, I guess. Although earlier today I wanted to diff a file, and it was like giving me attitude about that. I don't know what that was about. Yeah, I think I've tried that before, and I've had mixed results with. This is still the old build. You can tell because of the size of the grid. I did Control F5. Yeah, I don't know what that's about. Like sometimes I'll just hit refresh and it will get the new build, and then sometimes I'll hit refresh and it won't. This build might work for you, but if the grid, like if the game starts and like these buttons are covering up the top row, then that's the old build because I changed the dimensions in the new build. And so if you get that, then by going to P2, you can, wait, what did I do? Uh-oh. Wait, what happened to the banner and stuff? Where'd the banner go? Did I forget to add the banner? Where's the level banner? What did I do to the level banner? I forgot what I did to the level banner. Is this just gone? What did I do to the level banner? I am a funny person. Level banner? No, it's still there. Where'd it go? Oh, what? Main camera? Oh, it's like, why did I put it there? Oh, God. Oh, no. What happened to all this transfer? Oh, my God, my things got all moved around. All right, that build is a mess. Don't even bother. Oops. Don't even bother with that build. Well, I mean, you can bother with it, because the gameplay probably works just fine, but, like, the UI is completely gone. What on earth? Level banner is supposed to be... well, for one thing, it's supposed to be visible anywhere. Level banner. What the McGurk? What's the McGurk? Why can't I move this around or anything? Ugh. I don't know what that's about. I have no clue what this is about. Why do you not... Why do you hate me? let's switch out a 2D view for a minute. So, level banner. Where's the level banner? It's right there. Why is it stuck inside the... Is that... I mean, I guess level banner and level number don't really have to be inside the camera. But, like, what the hell happens then? Why can't... Oh, okay. Now I can move it, I guess. But, like, it's still not showing up on camera? What the hell? It's not hidden or anything. What the hell happened to my assets? Ah, this is obnoxious. So this is the type of last minute bug that I always freak out about, and apparently with good reason, so. What on earth is happening? Oh, I set the scale for the camera down to zero? That is bizarre. I don't know what that is about. But it's probably whatever is happening to, Okay, so wait, before I... Alright, I don't know why the scale of the camera is zero. That's just weird. Let's set it back to one and hopefully all will be right in the world. No? The scale of all of these things got zeroed out, which is ridiculous. Alright. How does that even happen? Alright, well that's annoying, but I can fix it at least. Although, actually the scale was like weird on a lot of these things, so for some of these things it's gonna be like... Ugh. Oops. What the heck is... If anyone knows what happened to make that happen, I would be curious to know. Oh wait, this is supposed to be point one. You're way too easy. You're clearly new to this game, so I'm not gonna hold it against you. But never mind. You'll figure it out. I'm just kidding. You're not way too easy. I don't know why I said that. I was lashing out. But I started this game like 24 hours ago, so like, give me a break. How about maybe a break? If you felt like giving me a break at some point, that'd be cool. Where did I put this before? It was like close, so like, yeah, probably, I don't know, 5, that's fine, whatever. Level number. This is like also a place. 2.5. I guess middle center. Yeah. Oh wait, was the level banner 2.5 or was it 2.25? I forget. It was definitely 2.25. So this should probably be as well. Alright, so X banner. That is the same as the other one, as the level banner. My freaking assets. Alright, anyways, 2.25, 10, 1.5, I think it was, or no, wait, yeah, that seems fine, I forgot what the... is it something programmatic that's like doing this to my scene? Like, is it, if I run it again, is it gonna be local position equals new vector? Well, maybe I'll just, I don't know, if this happens again, I'll just hide the UI while doing this instead of, yeah, I won't, nothing will be parented to the main camera, because that's apparently madness. Yeah, whatever, I'm just gonna save them while I still can, while they still stand a chance. Alright, so, oh yeah, I should show these things so I can put them in the right, the right place. X banner, I guess I'll put that, I don't know, same place as level banner.